Let us move on to the next transaction, which is on 14th. On 14th, you have a transaction, issued check to Hari. The meaning of issued check to Hari is the business has given check to Hari. So, it is a payment. So, any payment, you know, we have to record it on the credit side. Now, at the same time, there is also discount received along with this transaction. So, we will be using discount received for recording discount and bank column for recording the check amount. So, how do we record this transaction? 9600 we record in bank column and 400 we record in discount received column. Now, you know buy is constant and we have to write name of Hari because to Hari we are making the payment. So, hence that is the case. Now, the date is 14th December, so 2012, 14 December. Now, let us move on to the next transaction, which is on 20th. It is paid commission again payment. So, we will record the amount in cash column 500. Again writing by, the reason is commission, the date being 20th. Now, the next transaction is on 23rd. It is a check received from Govind, allowed discount to him. Whenever you receive check, you should also read the next transactions until the end and confirm whether any date for check deposited of is given. If you see this problem, on 23rd you are receiving check from Govind and next transaction immediately 25th states that Govind check deposited into bank. Means on 23rd you got check from Govind, on 25th you are depositing in bank. So, whenever you have the date of deposit, the treatment will be this way roughly. The day you receive check, treat it as cash received. Then, the day you deposit, on day of deposit, you have to treat it as a contra and transaction. You have to treat it as cash deposited into bank as if you are depositing cash into bank. So, based on this explanation, let us record this transaction. You received the check on one date and you deposited it on a different date. So, on 23rd you received, I am just giving the date first. So, on 23rd you received check from whom? That is Govind. So, what did we discuss? We have to record it in cash column. So, first I will write to Govind, recording the amount in cash column, that is how much? 3500, and discount allowed 500 in discount allowed column. Now, on 25th, you are depositing this 3500 check into the bank. Okay, you are depositing this 3500 into the bank. So, let us recall our journal entries. So, whenever you deposit anything into bank, you say bank is the receiver and debit bank. So, bank account debit. Now, here we are saying the check is being deposited, but when we received the check, we have treated it like cash. So, hence we write a contra entry, that is bank account to cash. Using this knowledge of your basic journal entry, you complete this transaction. So, what we must do? We must debit bank account. So, on the debit side, write the amount in bank column. The reason is cash. So, I write to cash. Then, the date is 25th. Now, in the same transaction, we should also credit cash. So, go to the credit side. Enter the amount of 3500 in cash column And the reason is bank. So write by bank. Now the date being 25th. Now on 25th, you are entering the amount related to one transactions on both the sides, because you have the columns of the accounts getting affected on both the sides. So this is called contra entry. Since this is a contra entry, in the LF column you write letter C on both the sides. It indicates there will be opening of no other ledger with reference to these amounts, as cash book is both journal and ledger for cash and bank accounts. Next, the next transaction is on 26th, it was bought furniture. So purchase of furniture, it's a payment. So go to the credit side, enter the amount in cash column 2000, and you know buy is constant. The reason is you are buying furniture, so write furniture in particulars column, and the date being 26th. Next transaction is on 28th, which states that withdrawn from bank cash for office use, or withdrawn from bank for office use. What you withdraw from bank? You withdraw cash, and it is stated office use. That means you require money for your activities in business. So you are taking out money from the bank and bringing it to your business or office, whatever it is. So it is again a contra entry, wherein by cash and bank accounts are involved. So if you remember your journal entries, cash is coming in based on real account rule, we debited. So cash account debit to bank is the giver of the money, so bank account credit. So remember this in your mind, and now record it in cash book. So cash we have to debit, so on the debit side enter the amount in cash column, the amount being 5000. So I am entering in cash column. Now the reason is bank is the giver, so to bank I am writing bank, and also we know it's a contra entry because cash and bank are involved. I am writing C in the left column, and then I am writing the date 28th. Now since bank also is involved, it's a contra entry, we should record in the other side also. The bank should be credited, so on the credit side in the bank column enter the amount 5000. The reason is cash, so give enter cash in particulars column. It's a contra entry, so C in LF column, the date being 28th December, so enter the date. Now let us move on to the last transaction on 30th, salaries paid by check. On 30th, salaries paid by check. So it is a check payment, so we have to record in bank column, and it's a payment, so on the credit side. So go to the credit side and enter the amount in bank column. Why? Because it is a check payment. The reason for the payment is salaries. So by salaries. So the date is on 30th December.